Good evening. I tried a chain pour today and I had the background way too heavy. This is the board. It has a coat of paint on it. Tonight I'm just going to try something a little different. I'm just going to use a big brush. Throw a few drops of color for a background. I don't know that I'm going to do a chain pour. Started thinking of a different one I'm going to try. Can't think of what they're called at the moment, but it'll come in my head. So first I'm going to get a background on here, and I'm just going to spread it out really thin. Because today it was just way, 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 way too thick. I had nothing but balling up happening. And I have to remember to put a little bit of water in the colors before I do it too, because they were too thick. Because it's something you really don't want is thick colors either. Anyway. Oops. Throwing paint all over. I changed my background because, or all my paper because it was getting so colored. I always paint on the same place and then I put it on a drying rack. I have a, I think it was for drying clothes. It's made out of metal. I had it for years and I just thought, perfect drying rack. So once they're done dripping, I move them to that. I might need a little bit more and then I'm going to put a little bit of color. Just not sure. I was hoping this brush would kind of level out the paint better. But all we can do is try it. Like I said, I wiped all the paint off of this. I got another idea I want to do too. I think it's going to be more brush work. I think not only will I do some pouring videos, but I'm slowly going to work into some other painting ideas I have. I like to do paintings too. But we just play and paint. It's all about just doing a little bit of paint. That's what I figure. What I'm doing is I'm just going to put a little bit of the greens in for background so the background isn't completely white. I'm not going to cover it completely. And I was thinking maybe a little bit of the blue, a few drops. I have all these colors mixed up from another painting, so they're all, like I said, Saks paints mixed with Floetrol. Some of the titanium white is I gotta think of the paint. It'll come to me in a second. Retrotech. I'm hoping just by doing this, I'm going to get the paint thin enough. But what I was kind of thinking of, first, I was also going to put a little bit of green out, which I'm not sure how this is going to work. Try not to, just so I can pull in a little bit of stems too. Might need my pokey sticks to get it down in, but straight lines, wouldn't you? Pull like that, though. I should do it wavy, because nothing in nature is really straight, is it? But it is just going to be the stem. I scraped off my thread, and I'll just throw it in the water. I'm going to start with this little fork. I glued a little string on it. And I'm going to try to vary between the two colors and do a droopy flower. Figure out how to do them, you see? That's the first thing. Different effect when you don't have as much paint on. Now this, I don't need as much paint on these either, so it's showing me that, isn't it? So I'm gonna work with different ones like that and kind of pull them in. Twisting them as they go to see what kind of flowers I get. Now maybe there should be one more. Kind of up here. Just wiping the thread off on my, I got a towel in my lap. So I was thinking I might get a little more control this way. I don't know. All I figure I can do is try. Right? Kind of turning the fork, so I'm kind of pulling it in. I'm dipping it kind of into two colors, so hopefully I'm getting a little variation on the petals. And just bringing them into the center with the twist. That's what I'm doing. Hoping it'll kind of give a flower shape as I do it, or petal shape. I got some yellow, so I might put some yellow on and put some little stamens in there, but just in play. To work at that angle. So I can get different angles of petals coming in. I'm sure some of you guys do that too. Move your... Oh, we do. We tilt them. Aren't we? Try to skid off a little bit of the two full ones. Okay, I'm going to bring one up in here. Just kind of twist. twisting and bringing it up. As we all know, every petal isn't perfect anyway. It's not like you have to get the perfect petal. Everyone is shaped different. Everyone is unique. See, then I get thinking. Do I need to, where's my, I had a pointy stick here. Oh, this'll do. Just bring a little bit of green up in there, get it a little fatter. Things can't be too regular, because if they are, they look strange. I think I should pull a leaf in, so what I'm going to do is dip this one into some green, touch it off a little, and bring in a leaf. Touch it into green again. Down. And bring it in. See, that one didn't work the way I wanted it, but then you just fix on it. The way you want it. Should almost have two different dishes of colors. But I really don't want my green to mix in with my other colors. Kind of twisting it so it tries to almost come to a line. You can always go back in and try to fix up the end if you want. And bring it in. Blanch the green one off a little bit. Just to get some of the paint off. Rubbing it in my towel. Putting in different because every flower is going to come in different places. Not all up top, not all. Sometimes you're going to see a side view, sometimes you're going to see more of a butt. almost say sometimes using it. I wouldn't say a brush, but same idea, I guess. Thinking of how the petal would go. Different shading from just pulling it in. I was also thinking another flower. I think I'm just going to try pulling up a few. Let's see if I can get the idea of what I wanted. It's kind of, it's not a, kind of like a lupin, but not really, just all blue. Flowers all down the stem. So I should get some form of stem would be the next step, wouldn't it? I want to kind of draw it not straight. Well, that doesn't work for that. So, okay. You need one of your sticks. That's okay. We're going to be putting other stuff in here anyway. Basically just using a stick. The worst thing about a stick is it doesn't hold much for paint. Almost better to have something like, maybe this is where the chain could come in. Try it, because it should come down in a wavy line how I pull it. It does tend to hold a little bit of paint. Not too much paint on your string. Wipe it off if you get other color in it. Just keep working down the stem. Best way for your own hand is to do it. Being there is too dry. But I guess that's part about getting the paint thinner like this. It's going to dry faster. And I'm going to have to work faster, aren't I? It's okay. It's all about the fun. did was glued a piece of thread onto a fork. I used Gorilla Glue. And glued it on, and then I'm just manipulating it till I get the effect I want. Oop. Now, how about a little bit of pink in there? Don't always have to be the same. In fact, that adds a little bit of oomph to it, doesn't it? Get a little bit in there, a little bit here and there. Get a rhythm or get an idea of what you're looking for. Okay, I'm going to pull another. See, nope, I just don't have the control. No more. I don't have the control with that. But that's alright. I can get fixed. I see that now. I can control. Maybe it's because I figured this stupid thing out. I'm looking for my scrap cup. Don't know what I did with it now. This one done because it's as we all know, you have to vary your amounts, your height. Everything too regular. It looks fake or nature doesn't do things regular. Nature does things irregular. Well, I mean there's a pattern, but don't get me wrong. That way. Some beautiful patterns in nature. Every day. Saying that nothing is usually too regular. So if everything, if something's off a little, it's all right. But yeah, I think maybe it's because the first thing I played with was a string. I'm just going to keep playing with it because it works for me better. green and I got blue and everything all over. Should have another piece of plastic. That's all I would need. Another piece of plastic. It's red, so I get two greens on it. Might work this way. Okay, so you see, this background's getting a little dry already. So, what would you do to fix that? Excuse the chair. You missed it. So how do you keep it wet on your palette? You missed it. And, and you'll get a different effect too. All about experimenting. See what works. Trying different things. Right? I should have thought about that because I do know what it does when you canvas. So, throw in a few more grasses. Get a few more different techniques in there. Cool techniques. Maybe something you really like. worst that can happen. Doesn't work? Oh well. Do another one. Right. And you know, sometimes what you don't like, somebody else just absolutely adores. We'll give anything a try. Just paint. The main thing is to paint. Basically, putting different grasses in just by smacking it around, slipping it down, dropping it in. Nothing can be the same. Can't be too regular. Now, I'm going to do another one. So, first, I guess, dummy, I shouldn't call myself that, silly, pull your stem in. Sometimes, but it's a little.